guys, thanks for joining me today. I'm on a brief trip to Tamarindo, Costa Rica, so I thought I would film some classes in this beautiful setting outdoors. That said, it is the end of windy season, so we might have to contend with a couple of gusts along the way, like right now. This class is a request for yoga for rock climbers. And like all of my sports related classes, I just want to remind you, you don't have to be a rock climber to practice this class. It's yoga. It just has some very specific focuses. And the focus for rock climbers in this class are going to be our hands, core strength, hip openers, and balance. And we'll mix in some other stuff along the way as well. I want to start with a pranayama today that I don't know if I've included in any of my other videos, but it's called Robin's Breath, and it's a physically active pranayama that opens and expands the chest and the upper back, which again is great for rock climbing. I am not currently a rock climber, but having been an active outdoors enthusiast in the past and currently, and a Colorado native, I grew up rock climbing. So a lot of this stuff I can really connect to in my body and help give you the cues and the reminders of what's needed along the way. So start in a comfortable seated position. Come onto your sitting bones on your mat. Bring your hands to your heart. We're just going to take 3 breaths with thumbs pressed to sternum, and then we'll start our Robin's Breath pranayama. So close your eyes, inhale through your nose, hold it at the top. Let it go through your mouth. Two more. This time close your lips and exhale through your nose. Open your eyes and just follow along as I cue you through Robin's breaths. Inhale with your hands at your heart. As you exhale, you're going to shoot your fingertips straight forward. Inhale, blossom your arms open, lift your gaze. Chin comes up off the chest, elbows draw back and down. And then exhale, you're going to bring the palms of your hands to touch. And this time you're going to dip your chin toward your chest. You're going to get a stretch in your upper back and neck. And then inhale back to heart center. Go just a little bit faster. So exhale, keep your head upright. Shoot your palms forward. Inhale, blossom your arms. Exhale, chin to chest, palms connect. Hands to heart as you breathe in. Breathe out, hands straight forward. Big inhale, blossom your arms, open your chest. Exhale, dip your chin, connect your palms. Let's do a couple more rounds. Breathe in, hands to heart. Breathe out. Exhale, connect your hands. Breathe in. Last time, breathe out. Blossom. Hands together, chin dips. Hands back to heart center. And then rest your palms down on your knees. I'm gonna start with a spinal twist. So reach your arms up overhead. You're gonna take your left hand to your right knee, your right hand out behind you. And then just peek out over your shoulder. Keep your spine upright and your shoulders stacked over your hips. Come back to center, reach up, and then switch sides. Come back to center. Let's take a chest expansion. Take your hands behind your back. Interlace your fingers. Press your fists down, lift up. And then hinge forward as far as you can and reach your arms up over the back of your head. slight bend in your elbows. Come all the way back up. Release your hands, place them back on your knees. We're gonna do some stomach grinds. This is a really good warm-up for your core, and it builds flexibility in your spine. So take your hands to your knees and take a nice firm grip. You're gonna just puff your chest out, lift up, and then you're gonna shift to your right. Long stretch through your side. Come forward, sitting bones stay on the ground and your spine is long. Shift to the left. So you're getting a nice stretch through your right side here. Now as you come back, you're gonna round your spine. So you're gonna get, again, a nice stretch to your upper back, separating your shoulder blades. Okay, now we're gonna do that again. We're gonna pick up the pace. So just start going around in circles. This is why you want the tight grip on your knees. So as you come back, just keep that connection. Start going a little bit faster for 3, 2, 1. Pause forward, and we're gonna start slow going the other direction. So feel that nice stretch through your left side as you lean to the right. Round as you come back, stretching between the shoulder blades. Stretch opposite side. Come forward with a long spine. And then just start going around in circles. You can start out slow. Start picking up your pace. Like I said, big gusts of wind. But since it's hot here, it actually feels good. For 3, 2, and 1. Pause, coming forward. And then just come sitting back up with a long, straight spine. From here, make your way into a tabletop position. Take 3 cat-cows at your own pace. So grounding down through your fingers, breathing in, dropping your belly, breathing out, rounding your spine. It's a nice spinal and core warm up. This is gonna be your last round. Breathing in, coming into cow pose. Breathing out, rounding into cat pose. Return to a flat back, tabletop position. We're gonna take thread the needle, which is a great warm-up for your arm and shoulder. So lift your left arm up, maybe gaze up at your fingertips, stretching through your left side, and then slide it on under behind your right hand, come onto your left ear, and just feel that stretch in the back of your left shoulder. Stretch it up. And release. There's a big iguana right up over my head. Switch sides. Lift your right arm up. And then slide that right arm behind your left hand. Come onto your right ear. Feel the stretch in the back of your right shoulder. And release. Coming all the way back up. Unwinding. Tabletop position. Let's take a hip stretch and lower back stretch, child's pose. Separate your knees to about mat distance apart. Bring your toes to touch and scoot your hips back to your heels. Lower your forehead down onto your mat and take 3 breaths in and out through your nose in this position. Feel the stretch in your hip flexors and your low back. Back up to a tabletop position and make your way to downward facing dog. Tucking your toes under, lifting your hips up, release your heels down. Start to pedal out your legs, bending one knee at a time. One more breath in this downward facing dog. And find stillness here, pressing both heels toward the floor. It's okay if they don't touch. You just want to get a stretch to your Achilles tendon and your calves and your hamstrings. Now look toward your hands, walk your feet to the front of your mat, bend your legs a lot, and dangle in ragdoll. take opposite hand to opposite elbow, or you can just rest your hands down on your mat, whatever is more comfortable for you. One more breath here. All right, so we can get a nice warm up here. We're gonna take three rounds of sun salutations. So go ahead and for your first, let's round all the way up to a stand slowly. Just let your arms dangle. Your head is gonna be the last thing to arrive. When you arrive in a standing position, go ahead and heel toe your feet to touch. Bring your arms down alongside your body for mountain pose. Palms face out. Close your eyes and just feel the stability in your feet so you can just kind of sway back and forth, maybe side to side, really connecting to the earth here. Engage the fronts of your legs, your quadriceps, so your legs are nice and tight. Lift through the crown of your head, and then on your next breath in, lift your arms up, tall mountain. And then exhale to forward fold. Hinge at your hips, reach off to your sides, all the way down, this time straightening the legs a little bit more than we did in ragdoll. On your breath in, lengthen your spine, monkey pose, flat back here, come back into a forward fold. Now plant your hands on your mat, step back to high plank. We're gonna hold high plank for the count of five, four, nice flat back here, three, slight bend in your elbows, two, press back through your heels, and one. Lower down onto your mat, elbows graze your ribs as you come down with control, nice and slow. As you breathe in, peel your chest up off of your mat for cobra pose. Draw your elbows in and then lift your hands up off of your mat so you can feel the full strength of your back working to hold you here for one more breath in. Lower all the way down. Tuck your toes under, press up high plank. You can keep your knees on the floor if you'd like, or lift them up off the floor, and then press back downward facing dog. One breath in and out. Okay, picking up the pace, breath to movement, look towards your hands, step, walk, or float to the front of your mat. Come into forward fold as you breathe out. Rise high, reach up. Maybe peek up, forward fold, come all the way back down. Monkey, lengthen your spine, and then chaturanga. You can step back high plank, knees up or down on the floor, lower chaturanga, halfway down, or feel free to come all the way down onto your mat. Flip over to the tops of your feet, press up, upward facing dog, downward facing dog. One breath, breathe in. Breathe out. Look toward your hands, step or float forward. Forward fold. Tall mountain. Forward fold. Monkey. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Lift your right leg up, open your hip and bend your leg. So again, we're gonna be focusing a lot on hip opening. So just feel the stretch in the front of your right hip flexor as your right foot dangles down toward the floor. Now bring your hips so they're back level with each other. Straighten your legs straight out behind you and step your right foot forward between your hands. Lower your back knee down onto the floor. We're gonna take crescent moon pose, another fabulous stretch for your hips. You can have your back toes tucked under or foot flat to the floor. Reach both arms up overhead. So we can get a bonus shoulder stretch here. Connect the palms of your hands together and then take your thumbs to the back of your head. Press head to thumbs, thumbs to head. Start to lift your gaze, elbows draw up toward the ceiling. If you have a really flexible upper back, which I don't, you might come into what looks like an upper back bend. Reach your arms back up, lower your hands back down onto your mat. begin to straighten through your front leg. And then reach your forehead towards your toes. You're getting a stretch in your hamstring, the back of your right leg. This is called half splits pose. And then bend your right knee so it's right back over your right ankle. Lift your left knee up off the floor. We're gonna come into standing splits position. So take all of your weight to your right foot. Pop that left foot up off the floor. Begin to straighten your right leg. And again, if it's way bent, that's all right too. Just work in that direction. So you're using a lot of strength in your standing leg. All right, now we're gonna step that left foot lightly back down to the mat with an angle in your foot. So you're gonna come down, left heel lowers to the floor. Begin to straighten your right leg. We're gonna come from this position into triangle pose. It's not usually the way we get into it, but we're gonna try it today. So begin to straighten your right leg. You can have your right hand either on a block, on your shin, on the floor, and then start to open up through your left side as you rotate your chest to the side and you lift your left arm up. Triangle pose is another great hip opener, and you're building strength in your legs and flexibility in your spine. If you feel out of balance, take your gaze down. But if you want to challenge your balance, take your gaze up toward the sky, the ceiling. Now from here, start to reach your left arm forward. So you're getting a nice stretch in your left side. And as you practice today, if you are a rock climber, just kind of visualize yourself on the wall or on the rock face. Imagine that you're really working your body to get this longer stretch and reach. And it hopefully feels good. Feels good to me. Nice big stretch in your left side. Now bring your left hand down toward the mat. Look down, bend your right leg. And then let's just take a little vinyasa here if you'd like, high plank to chaturanga. So step back, lower down, stretch up, and back. Let's take that sequence of postures on the other side. Begin by lifting your left foot up, open your hip, and bend your leg. Let your left leg dangle down toward the floor, and just feel that stretch through your left hip flexor. You can always find movement in these postures so that you feel good and that you feel like you're getting the stretch that you need. Make adjustments. Your poses aren't gonna necessarily look like mine. Now, square off your hips, straighten your leg, and step your foot between your hands. We're preparing for crescent moon pose. You can lower your back knee down onto the floor. Again, toes tucked or flat. Reach your arms up overhead, aligning your wrists over your shoulders first and then lowering your shoulders down away from your ears. Now connect the palms of your hands and take your thumbs to the back of your head. Elbows point up, and then a little back bend here. Mine's a mini back bend, but maybe yours will be deeper as you take your gaze up. Let those hips sink down toward the floor and let your chest lift up toward the sky. Now come back to center, reach your arms up, lower your hands down onto your mat and begin to straighten your left leg. In forward fold over your left leg, getting a stretch in your hamstring on your left side. Half splits pose, Ardha Hanumanasana. Return to a low lunge position, taking your left knee over your left ankle. We're gonna come into standing splits. So take all of your weight onto your left leg, just pop off that right foot, lower your head down toward your toes. Again, left leg bent or straight, we're working in the direction of straight. That takes time, flexibility, strength, all of those great things that we're practicing today. Now, with grace and ease, lower your right foot way to the back of your mat, heel plants down at an angle, in preparation for Trikonasana triangle pose. Begin to straighten your left leg. And again, hand placement, it might even be different on this side, but you've got lots of options. So choose the hand placement that works for you. And then start to roll your chest open. Open through your right side and lift your right arm up. Choosing where to gaze based on how balanced you feel. I'm sure you can feel it. I didn't mention it on the other side, but this is also a nice, beautiful stretch for your left inner thigh. And I mention it now because I'm feeling it on this side and it feels really nice. Now stretch your arm forward. Imagine that nice long reach on the rock wall or on your climbing gym. Get your arm back up and then place your right hand on your mat. Left knee over left ankle for a low lunge position and a little vinyasa flow if you'd like it. High plank, chaturanga, upward dog or cobra, downward facing dog, rolling up and over your toes, pressing your heels down onto your mat. All right, core strength and stability is key for rock climbing, so we're gonna do a couple plank and plank variations. So shift forward to a high plank position. Try to get your shoulders directly over your wrists and nice flat back, your neck is long. Looking, gazing down at your mat. Tight, tight quadriceps, the fronts of your legs. Remember, modification for plank pose is to place your knees down on the floor. All right, now position your left hand directly under your face and you're gonna roll onto your left hand for side plank. Lift your right arm up. Now let's do that nice long reach again. So reach your right arm forward and lift your right foot up off of your left. One nice long line from your toes all the way to your fingertips. Foot down, arm up, switch sides. Roll onto your right side, lift your left arm up. Okay, left arm reaches forward. Left foot reaches up off your right. Strong, steady. Do you feel your core engaged and working? Belly button is drawing back toward your spine. Place your left foot down, left arm reaches up. Roll back to high plank, and then lower down onto your mat. So we want to strengthen our back body as much as we want to strengthen our front body. So we're going to take locust pose with chest expansion. Take your hands behind your back. Interlace your fingers. Another big gust coming up here. Press your fists towards your heels and then reach your feet up off of your mat. In all of our spine strengthening postures, be mindful not to throw your head back. Okay, I'm not even going to throw my back because I don't want to hurt myself, but you don't want to lift your chin too far up. You want to keep your neck open in the back. Continue to hold here, building strength in your back body, your glutes, your hamstrings, calves. Just really point through the balls of your feet. It's kind of a semi-flex point position. Okay, release down and then press back to child's pose. This is a counter pose to our locust. So you should feel a nice stretch in your low back, stretching your hips again. And return to downward facing dog. Okay, we're gonna work some standing balance poses and then we're gonna work some arm balance poses as well. So go ahead and walk yourself to the front of your mat. Take a halfway lift, lengthen your spine, and then come back into a forward fold, just continuing to build openness in the backs of our legs. Rise up tall mountain, bring your arms down alongside your body. Okay, so this is a standing balance posture, which is a deep hip opener as well. So you're gonna stand onto your left foot, bring your right leg up, you're gonna interlace your fingers around your right knee. So first thing you're gonna do is just kind of draw your left knee in, and then you're gonna take your left knee to your right knee, to the right, around your ribs, and further up toward your shoulder. Just emphasizing the opening in your hip. Okay, and bonus, we get to balance as well. So I just got distracted. So what I was gonna say is find a place to gaze, steady yourself, and just hold here. Actively squeezing your knee in so you get that hip opening. Your chest lifted, shoulders lowered, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And then we're gonna move into Garudasana, Eagle Pose, which is a great stretch for your upper back. So you're gonna wrap your right leg around your left, and then take your left arm underneath your right. Nice tight wrap here. Palms of your hands coming together. Sink your hips lower, building strength in your right leg. And last standing balance on this side. We're gonna come into a modified five-pointed star. So unwind, unwrap, and then reach everything up and out. Nice long reach of your arms, reach of your leg. Just visualize yourself expanding length of your arms. Nice and steady in your balance. Release. Let's take that standing sequence on the other side. Step onto your right foot. First, draw your left knee in, interlacing your fingers around your knee. And then bring it out and around your ribs. So out and then up. Steady yourself in your balance in your standing leg. This posture is also extremely good for your hands, your arm strength, if you're really active in this posture, squeezing up and in with your leg. We're gonna do this posture on the floor as well toward the end of our class. Okay, Eagle Pose. Wrap your left leg around your right, your right arm underneath your left. Sink your hips down, strong and steady in your balance. Okay, modified five-pointed star. Find that reach, extension, strength, and balance. And release to mountain pose. Set your foot down, arms reach down. Let's take another vinyasa here, optional. Reach your arms up. We're gonna meet in downward facing dog. Forward fold. Monkey. Chaturanga. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Look toward your hands, step or float through to a seated position. Let's take another core strengthener here. Navasana boat pose. Boat pose. Put your heels up off the floor, lift your chest, reach your arms. Hold. Maybe extending your legs straight. One more breath. I'm just gonna take one roll back, forward. We're gonna jump through to Chaturanga. So roll back, roll forward, you just cross your ankles. I'm into Chaturanga, so halfway down, and then press up, high plank. Do that two more times, lower halfway down, press up, lower down, press up, downward facing dog, press back. Lift your right leg up. Come into a half pigeon position, bringing your right knee toward your right wrist, right toes toward left wrist. This is gonna be a short hold in half pigeon. So first stretch long, and then option to come down onto your hands, or your forehead to your hands, optional here. Come back up onto your hands. Okay, and we're gonna continue to move into a hip stretch now on your other side. So sweep your left leg around and come into cradle the baby. For cradle the baby, hold on to your left foot with your right hand, left knee with your left hand. If you're pretty open, you can start to draw your shin in and wrap your arms around your left shin. Whatever position you're in or whatever your leg looks like, I want you to have your spine upright. So try to avoid hunching and rounding, and instead lift tall through the crown of your head. Okay, now while we're here, we're gonna do a little foot yoga. So you can just rest your foot down on your knee or your mat. I'm gonna take your hand and place a finger between each toe. See if you can get it in there. And then first flex your toes back. And then come back to center and take your thumb and start to massage the bottom of your foot. Give it a lot of pressure. So rock climbing shoes are super tight. They squish your toes. This is really good. This would be a great thing to do after you climb. You take your shoes off and get all that blood flowing back into your feet. You want to keep your feet healthy and flexible. Okay, and last little part of your foot yoga, release your toes and then take your hand to the top of your foot and then just press your toes toward your heels. So you're getting a stretch along the top of your foot. Maybe a couple little circles of your ankle here. All right, so let's return to downward facing dog. Just in preparation for half pigeon pose on your other side. So lift your left leg up. Sweep it forward. Get comfy so you feel a nice stretch in your hip. Stretch up tall, lower down if you'd like. Back up onto your hands, hip stretch for your other side. Sweep your right leg around for cradle the baby. So hold onto your knee and your foot. You're feeling pretty flexible. You can start to wrap your arms around your shin. I didn't say this on the other side, but be mindful that you keep your toes in alignment with your heel and that you're not doing anything really funky with your foot. Sit up tall. Try to avoid hunching and rounding your spine. And a little foot yoga on your other side. So you can just rest your foot down now. Spread your fingers, spread your toes. Place each finger between each toe, creating space, flexibility, and then give yourself a little massage on the bottom of your foot with your thumb. Apply quite a bit of pressure. Really get under the ball of your foot and get right into the center. Lots of pressure points in your feet. And again, if you're doing this right after rock climbing, I'm sure you'll feel it. You'll know where you need to go. Just getting that circulation, blood flow, to your feet, keeping your feet healthy. Oh yeah, now press your toes back. We did this first on the other side. Give them a real good stretch. Put a little muscle in there. And then take your hand to the top of your foot and press your toes towards your heels. This is a good warm-up too in practice if you're working on rolling over your toes from your up dog back to your down dog. Just the flexibility that's needed in your foot to make that a smooth transition. Okay, a couple rolls of your ankle. Okay, let's come back into a tabletop position. We're gonna warm up and stretch our wrists and our hands since we just did our feet, and then we'll do some arm balancing, okay? So come onto tabletop position. These are gonna be more gentle movements because you have weight on your wrists. So first of all, just rock back and forth. You should feel stretch in your arms, building flexibility in your wrists. If it feels okay, you have healthy wrists, just flip your hands so your fingers point back to your knees. Maybe bend your elbows. This is all gonna depend on the flexibility in your wrists and your forearms, so just try it out. Good stretch, no pain. You don't wanna tweak anything out here. Okay, and then this, even more gentle than the last, you're gonna come onto the tops of your hands now, so super, super gentle. Place your fingers so they're facing toward each other. And just straighten your arms and just a gentle rock side to side. Not a lot of weight, not a lot of pressure. If it feels good and you want to, you can make little fists. Ooh, that's a huge stretch for me. So good. Just like your feet, you gotta keep your hands super healthy and flexible for rock climbing. All right, one more nice shoulder stretch. Keep your hips over your knees. Walk your hands to the upper corners of your mat, then just lower your chest down. Walk your hands back up. You're gonna come onto your feet and come into a little ball. This pose is called ball of yarn, actually. So imagine a ball of yarn. Round your spine over, take opposite hand to opposite elbow, maybe tuck your chin. It's a little balance, stretch and strength for your feet. A nice stretch for your upper back as well. Okay, from this position, crow pose. Real traditional basic arm balance in yoga. Doesn't mean it's easy, but you're probably familiar with it. You're gonna take your shoulders right over your wrists and bring your knees high up onto the backs of your arms. And then just tip your weight forward. You can keep your toes on the floor if that's where you're at today, or maybe you can lift your feet up off of your mat. Drawing your heels towards your bum. Maybe working in the direction of straight arms. Hold it. And you're gonna just very lightly release back down. Good, and then come down onto your back. As promised, we're gonna do our wind removing pose on our back now, taking the balance component out of it. So lay down on your back, draw your right knee in, hands around your knee. So just the same as we did when we were on our feet. So draw it in first, then take your knee around your ribs and up toward your shoulder. Tight squeeze, use arm strength. Again, this is very good for your hands and your wrists as well. Elbows draw in and down, toes stay flexed back, left leg stays active. Okay, now relax the grip on your leg. Bring it back towards center and extend your right leg up toward the sky, the ceiling. Flex and point. You can continue to hold on to the back of your leg here, or if you are able to, you can reach your peace fingers around your right big toe, stretch for your hamstring, and we're gonna take this into an inner thigh stretch as well. You have two options. If you're holding onto your toe, bring your left arm straight out to the side, your palm flat to the floor, and you can open up your right leg to the right. Keep your left hip and left shoulder on the floor. If your right inner thigh is not interested in this position, you can always bend your leg and then just rest your knee down so you feel still that stretch in your right inner thigh. Come back towards center. Then we're going to take reclined pigeon pose. So bend your left leg or figure four pose. Cross your right ankle over your left knee. Bring your left knee up. Thread your hands through and around your shin. Flex your feet back. Draw your knee in further. Release your left foot down and then figure four twist. So place your left foot flat on the floor and twist right foot to the left, stamping onto your mat, and then just gaze towards your right. Come back to center. Extend your right leg long on your mat. Hug your left knee in. Hands around your knee. Take your knee to the left and up toward your shoulder. Flex your toes back and use the strength in your arms and your hands to more deeply compress your left hip. And then back towards center, extend your leg up. Little flex in point of your left foot. Okay, same options on this side. Hands around the back of your leg or peace fingers around your left toe. Hold here, stretching the back of your left hamstring. Let's take it into an inner thigh stretch. You remember the options, so whatever works for you, it could be different on this side. If you're opening your left leg straight, make sure that your right shoulder and your right hip stay glued onto the floor. You can help make this happen by extending your right arm to the right palm, pressing down into the earth. Back to center, figure four. Bend your right leg, stamp your foot to the floor, and then cross left ankle over right knee. Lift your foot up off the floor and then thread through, interlacing hands around your thigh or your shin. Very much appreciating this wind as I bake in the sun. So it's a little noisy, but it feels really good. Place your foot back on the floor, figure four twist. So right foot flat and then twist to the right so your left foot stamps on the floor and gaze to the left. Back to center. Last pose before Shavasana. Let's take happy baby pose. Separate your knees and feet. Hold on to whatever you have access to. Take some rocks side to side. Hug it in. Tight squeeze, flat back. Shavasana. Extend your legs long, let your feet gently fall open.
breathe into your nose and hold it. Let it go through your mouth. Return to the natural rhythm of your breath. If you have the time, continue to rest in your shavasana. Thanks so much for joining me on your mat today. Today, as you go forward, may you have peace in your thoughts and your words and your heart. From my heart to yours, namaste.